All right, Patrick here at Master Tech Diesel Injection in Boise, Idaho. Today we're going to be doing a video giving the inner workings of the Stanadyne DE injection pumps. These are most commonly found in John Deere and industrial ag applications. This one here is a four-cylinder out of a John Deere 6120. This is a six-cylinder that we have disassembled and cleaned up. That's out of a John Deere 7420 application with a 6068H intercooled engine. And we're just going to go through some of the common issues that we find with these pumps, why they come in for repair, what the common failures are. The most common failure we see, which is probably about 90%, is due to this fuel control solenoid here. And this fuel control solenoid fails and no longer controls the quantity of fuel injected or the timing at which it is injected into the engine. Unfortunately, the solenoid cannot just simply be replaced on the engine because it has a very special setting that is controlling your poppet valve travel, which controls the timing of injection inside the engine. And this is adjusted with this special crush washer. Crush washer goes down in here, like so, and there's a very special torque sequence that sets the poppet valve lift. Which can only be done at an authorized fuel injection shop that has the proper assembly equipment as well as the calibration equipment to verify that the timing procedure was done correctly and that the proper poppet valve lift was done. Some of the other common failures that we see on these is the transfer pump liners can fail. This one's in really good shape. They'll get really bad flakes inside the liners. They'll start to crumble and fall apart. The transfer pump blades can get excessively worn. You can see here that there is a little bit of a wear marks here on these blades. The drive shafts can also get excessive seal groove and cause a crankcase dilution problem. Also, the shoulder here that the needle bearing assembly right here rides on can also go flat or start to flake and chunk out inside of the injection pump. Sometimes these cam rings can also get flaking, and they'll eventually go flat, and it can cause a misfire, a dead injection. It also causes metal to go through the injection pump. Another less common issue but does still occur is a heat soak problem where the tractor won't start when it's hot. And this is caused by excessive hydraulic head and rotor wear. Very tight tolerances between these two components that ride together. This is what actually pumps the fuel. And if that tolerance gets too sloppy, then it will not be able to generate the necessary quantity of fuel and pressure to start the engine. That is a very expensive fix to replace this assembly. Fortunately, it is not a common failure on them. We will also be going through in a later video how to properly time these injection pumps to the engine. Your timing port is through here. You take this plug out. And we've got a timing pin that goes down in here so we can pin time the pump. And then you pin time the motor, and then they both bolt up together. Unfortunately, a lot of these tractors will have multiple pin locations in the flywheel. And this is a very commonly misinstalled injection pump to the engine. And we will do an instructional video to show how to properly time this pump to the engine so that this does not happen. Stay tuned.